Hello, a very good morning to you all students. Hope as we have started our second chapter yesterday, that is components of food. So first half that we have completed, 1/4 part of that, it was clear to you all about the carbohydrates and about the sources of carbohydrates, what are the main components, that so on. Now today we are going to discuss our lecture. We are going to start lecture with the second component, that is fats. What are fats? Actually, what happens if we are taking fats in our daily food? Fats are also energy giving food. In fact, they provide more energy than carbohydrates. Fats are composed of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Clear? That means the same we can say, as we have found that carbohydrates are also composed of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Similarly, fats are also providing us energy, but more than carbohydrates. This in our, what happens, food converts into energy if we are taking, and the part of some energy is stored in our body as fats. So what are the main functions of fats? Actually, we know that fats act as a energy bank to a living organisms, okay, and it protects the delicate, that we can say those types of organs which are soft in nature, soft, they used to protect that important organs of our body. The fat under the skin acts as an insulator, cutting down heat loss in cold weather, and it thus helps to keep the body warm. So now what happens, as we are too healthy in our body, so it's an insulator, like that no heat can pass. You know very well that during winter season we used to wear woolen clothes. Why? Because the warm air are trapped between the layers of woolen clothes, therefore we feel hot from inside and cold from outside. That's why the same fat acts as an insulator for the body, so that it can keep the body warm. So what are the sources of fats? From where you can get fats? Sources of fats are classified into two groups. That is, first one, animal fats, butter, ghee, milk, meat. And plants, from plants, what type of fats we are taking? That is mustard oil, groundnut oil, nuts, etc. These are the important sources of fats. Clear? So you can see over here, see, these are butter, ghee, milk, meat, nuts. This all provides us energy. While if we are taking, we are able to do work more energy while having carbohydrates. The next comes is our experiment. What happens if we are just taking this? See, what you have to do over here, just a simple, see this, both the pictures, you can understand. Just I am dictating, you have to read out this property. We have taken a burner, see, over burner's gas is there. This is called Bunsen burner, because this is actually used in laboratories while doing experiments. Okay, this is a burner, this is a test tube, and we are just holding with the stock the test tube over the heat. So now what we are doing, we are taking a small amount of food. As we are eating such a small amount of food, that we are taking anything solid, we used to crush means, you know, that we have to bind them into small particles, and we are just putting that food particles into this test tube and keep it over heat for heating. It will burn. After some time we are going to add some water to the test tube and we will shake them, okay. And after that, after heating about 1 minute, what we will be doing, we will keep it aside to cool down, okay? And as it cools down, we will add a few drops of iodine solution within the test tube, in which little bit of water and food particles were burned and then kept for a while to cool down. So what observation we see, that this food which is burned and cooled down, after adding that iodine solution, it turns simply into blue black color. Why does it happen? Because in food, you know, our simple carbohydrates are present in the form of starch, isn't it? Foods which you are eating, you know, they having starch. And if not, then what? No color change will be there. In food, usually we get starch and it's burned. And as we know that iodine solution is the best test for starch, so we did to search out whether the food contains starch or not. We tested and we observed our conclusion that change in the color of the food sampled to bluish black confirms the presence of starch. That means this taste tube must have starch contained in the food. That is why only after adding iodine solution, it changes its color, that is bluish black. So it is confirmed, and you can understand by the following experiment that why such things is important for us. Okay. Now next, there comes a transplant. We can see a food sample of filter paper. We have to take a test for fats. You know, usually fats are butter, ghee, milk, meat, nuts of this, mustard, etc. So before just going through this experiment or test, I want to ask something, that while keeping your, we can say this, as we have taken some thing, it means oily, whatever, because whatever we can say, they are usually prepared either by ghee or either by oil. So when we keep on a paper, what happens? The portion on which we used to keep that food item over the paper, from that portion the food becomes little bit, we can say translucent, means little we can see from both the side, isn't it? Yes or no? Yes na? Yeah. The thing is that only in this, what they are taking? They are taking a simple food sample and a filter paper. And what they are doing over here? They are rubbing the food sample on a clean filter paper or keep it between the folds of the filter paper. Then what we are observing? A transparent mark or oily stain appears on the filter paper. So what does we conclude? The appearance of oil stain or translucent veins confirm the presence of fat. मतलब पेपर में जब हम खाना रखते हैं, है ना, तो क्या होता है, ऑयली फूड रखते हैं कुछ भी, तो वो ट्रांसलेंट होता है, मतलब पूरा दिखता नहीं, थोड़ा थोड़ा आर पार का दिखता है ना? Yes or no? This is the thing happens. एंड यही प्रेजेंट करता है कि फूड सैंपल में हमारे फैट्स भी प्रेजेंट है. फर्स्ट एक्टिविटी विच वी डिड, दैट इज अबाउट द स्टार्च, दैट फूड कंटेन स्टार्च. एंड द सेकेंड एक्टिविटी वी डिड इज एग्जैक्टली द सेम, वी हैव टू सर्च अबाउट फॉर द फैट्स, सो दैट इज ऑल्सो कन्फर्म. नाउ बोथ द थिंग्स हैव बीन कन्फर्म बाई यू. नाउ वॉट यू ऑल टू डू? Today we have discussed about fats and two activities, isn't it? About fats, you know very well what would I like to say. Now for the activities, what you have to do? You have to complete both the activities. Activity 1, to test for starch in the food sample and the stretch the test for fats in a given food sample. Both the activities with proper diagram you have to complete in your FAIR notebook. And I hope that you all will complete your work with a good and best handwriting. As you all are, you know that you all are at your home and you have to just complete your work as we are saying you. Day by day, days will be passed, but you know the past days will not be returned. Yes or no? So you have to complete your work properly and on time. So try to complete your work on time. Okay? So in the next lecture, we are going to discuss about proteins, vitamins, maybe minerals also, as the chapter says what we have to do. But the one thing is that the portion till now I have taught you, you have to read out, and if a single doubt comes in your mind, you should ask me to recover it. First thing. Second, I have given you the work, you have to complete in your notebook. Okay? Thank you for today and have a nice day for tomorrow.